Hi there, this is Vadim Mikhailenko, and in this video we're going to look at how you can turn your Windows 10 computer, which might be laptop, desktop, or tablet, into Wi-Fi hotspot. So stay here with me on this channel. First, let's take a look at why turning on your Windows computer into hotspot might be useful to you.
Having your own Wi-Fi hotspot might be helpful for business travelers if the hotel, for example, whose Wi-Fi system uses captive portal login, limits the number of connections allowed and charges for additional connections. Or you might be trying to find use for your old desktop and create another Wi-Fi hotspot in your house for the guests. Since desktop is always connected and typically connected through the LAN connection, you just need a Wi-Fi card in your desktop to convert it to the Wi-Fi hotspot. Whatever your case is, having this additional tool to create the Wi-Fi hotspot is extremely useful. And now you can do it in Windows 10.
Now let's look at the system requirements you need to turn on your Windows 10 computer into Wi-Fi hotspot.
There are three main requirements to enable Wi-Fi hotspot on Windows 10. First of all, you would need to have Windows Wi-Fi adapter installed on your Windows 10 computer. To find out if you have network adapter installed, you would need to click the Start button, type Control Panel, go into Control Panel, and select Device Manager, and within Device Manager, expand Network Adapter section. In the example I'm showing, Qualcomm Aeris wireless adapter is installed. Second thing, you also would need an existing internet connection that you're planning to share. Windows 10 allows you to share Ethernet, wired or LAN connections, or Wi-Fi or cellular connections. To find out if you have existing internet connection, you need to click the Start button, type Control Panel, and then navigate to Network and Sharing Center. In the example I'm showing you, there is an existing Ethernet connection that we'll be able to share.
Are you enjoying this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you're not missing the next one, and tell your friends about it so they will learn more skills in the area. Now let's continue and have more fun.
And the third thing, you would need to be logged in into Windows with administrator account. To confirm that you have administrator account, you need to click the Start button, go to Control Panel, go to User Accounts, and then check what kind of account do you have. In this example, the video demo account that I have on my virtual machine is an administrative account and password protected account.
And now, let's look at the step-by-step tutorial how you can actually turn it on into Wi-Fi hotspot.
Turning Windows into Wi-Fi hotspot is a multi-step process. All the steps are done in the Settings, Network, Internet, Mobile Hotspot area. So now let's look at those steps step by step. Click the Start button and then select Settings. In Settings, click Network and Internet and then go to Mobile Hotspot. As you can see, by default, there is no network name selected and there is no password. It is also turned off by default. And here on the screen, what you can do, you can select which internet connection are you planning to share. Let's configure network name and network password first. Select the values that you would like to expose on your Wi-Fi hotspot, give it a name, and also select the secure password. I'm not going to go into details about selecting secure password here, but I would recommend you research secure passwords and give it a secure value. There are certain rules that you need to use to give your system secure password to make sure you avoid compromise. Once you save your settings, you just need to share your internet connection with other devices. And then you turn the switch from off to on. And now, as a last step, let's validate our connection to make sure it's working. I will be using iPad, but you can connect from any device that supports Wi-Fi. To connect from iPad, I'll go into Settings, select Wi-Fi, and select the network we've just created, which is Windows 10 Mobile Hotspot. and then attempt to connect. Type in the password, and then in the last step, we would like to test the connection in the browser just to make sure it's working.
Have you enjoyed this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you will not miss the next one, and tell your friends about it. You can find links and downloads in the description section of this video. There are a lot of helpful links and a lot of other helpful information you will benefit from.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.